Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative 15-minute AE tutorial. This is part 2 in our Text Animator series. If you haven't seen the previous episode, do that now or after you watch this tutorial, and start creating your own personal library of text animators. Today we'll be creating 3 more text animations to add to what we did last time. I'll also be showing you a ton of tips, tricks, and shortcuts, so you don't want to miss this tutorial. As always, there's no BS, just AE. This episode is sponsored by the good folks over at AE Juice. Check out their site by visiting the link in the description below to get amazing savings, as well as AE assets that are 100% free. If you're a serious motion graphic designer, you'll be super happy you discovered AE Juice. I personally recommend their I Want It All bundle, which gives you access to everything that they offer. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and visit them today using the link in the description below. Be sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Trust me, you won't regret it. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you thought about this episode. Hopefully you'll learn something new and useful. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, to the impressive deals and all the free stuff you can get from AE Juice, the presets we've created over the past 2 episodes, the notes, and the project files are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and watch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's pick right back up where we left off last time. We created 3 text animations with text animators that can be used in a number of projects. All you have to do is bring in your preset and change the text. Remember to add a mask to animations you want to appear or disappear to avoid using alpha mats and cluttering up your timeline. Also, remember to enable motion blur on all text animations. It just looks better and it's more professional. For part 2 of our text animator series, our first text animation will be using the tracking text animator. Okay, let's go to our text layer, choose animate, and then let's add a text animator for tracking right here. Let's change this value for tracking so our characters are really far apart. You can use any value you'd like. I'm going to set this to 430 something. It doesn't have to be exact. The main thing is we want to get the right look and the right distance between our letters. And again, we want to make some adjustments here. We want to make our shape is going to be ramp up, and we want to go to negative 100%. That's our beginning animation. Put a keyframe, go forward 20 frames, and make this last one 100%. So if we just kind of watch this playback and enable motion blur, we have something that looks kind of like that, which is kind of cool, but I want it to animate on a little bit differently. So if we go back to the beginning here, and let's just name this N. With this text animator highlighted, because you want to put more animators within this group, we want to add in an opacity. And now let's make this opacity text animator 0. So that way it starts off at 0, but it ends at 100. And the reason why it does that is our layer's opacity. So see, if we hit T for opacity, our layer's opacity is set to 100%. So what the text animator does is it alters that value, but it animates using this offset. Even though our opacity is set to 0% here, that's the starting value. So once it gets through this animation, the final value of our opacity will be the value of the opacity at the layer level. Basically, whatever you have your layer set to with regard to position, scale, rotation, opacity, those will be the values once your text has animated in. So everything that's within this N text animator is being controlled by this offset as well as by this shape, and we'll increase our ease load to 100%. So that's controlling all of that. And we can actually add in one more thing. With N highlighted, let's go to animate. Let's add in a blur. Now we can increase this blur, we'll say to 100 pixels. And as this animates in, you can see the blur is coming in with it too. And again, this blur animation is being controlled by this offset. So I think that's a really cool animation, and I just want this to animate right back out the way that it animated in. So again, we can highlight these keyframes, copy, paste, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes. So this is our animation in and our animation out. And notice too, all of our keyframes are linear keyframes. We're not easing anything. Like, you could right click, keyframe assistant, do like an easy ease or easy in or out. By using this ease low and ease high, you don't have to even worry about using easing functions at the layer level. Let's make this into a preset. So we're going to click on text, transform, animation, save animation preset. Call this tracking, blur, opacity. So that way I know it includes all of those text animators. Okay, and then let's get rid of this layer here. Go back into our effects and presets, user presets, 7 minute AE, and it's this text animator right here. So we want to make sure we put our playhead at the beginning of the timeline. Double click, and if we hit U, we can see that all of our keyframes came back in, and once again, everything is exactly as we saved it. I can change this to Jeff Knight, 7 minute AE tutorials, and I want to right click, transform, center anchor point and layer content, and then just go ahead and center this up. And it's the same exact animation, just with different text. So this is a really cool text animation that can be used in any number of situations. Here's just a few more I want to go through real quick. So this is going to be 3D text. So I'm going to our text layer. If we go to Animate and choose Enable Per Character 3D, we get this icon here which indicates that each character is 3D. Now we need to add in a position text animator. And again, we want to change our initial value. We'll make this negative 1500. And we want to open up our range selector in advanced. We want to change this from square to ramp up. Negative 100% on the offset. So that's our starting position. Put a keyframe there. Go for 20 frames and increase that to 100%. Increase our ease load to 100%. So we have something that looks kind of like this. Now there's some really cool things we can do with this. This isn't really that impressive yet, but if we make just a few adjustments, we can make this look really, really cool. So let's make sure we go to animator one, and again, let's change this to N. And then if we add in an opacity text animator within that, it will use the values of these offset keyframes. Decrease our opacity down to zero. So it goes from zero to 100%. And then I also want to add in that blur. So just highlight N, animate, blur. And I just want to make this 100 pixels. And this is one of those times where it's going to look better if you enable this randomized order. So let's just click that on and then watch this. And it just looks a lot better instead of going from beginning to end or end to beginning. And this even works if we change this to words. It'll animate in each word at a time. I think for this particular animation, characters probably works best. And then if we want to animate this back off, all we have to do is copy, paste these keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes, and the animation we get is like this. Okay, and once again, we can save this as a preset. Highlight text, transform, animation, save animation preset. It brings back to our folder here. Rename this 3D text. Okay, and then let's get rid of this layer. Go back to our effects and presets, animation presets, user presets, 7 minute AE, and here is our 3D text. So we want to make sure we put our playhead at the beginning of the timeline. Double click, hit U to bring up our keyframes. We can see that everything's saved. And again, this is a pretty cool text animation that can be used in any number of cases. Now make sure, again, that you always enable your motion blur. Whenever you bring these text animators back in, it will not bring your motion blur in with it because there's no setting for that. So you have to remember to enable your motion blur every time you bring in a text animation. But this just looks so much better. Okay, and then there's one more text animation I want to go over, and it's going to be two lines. So basically, I want to put a line here in the middle that divides these two layers, and I want the top line to animate from the bottom line to animate from the top. So let's just go in here and add in a new shape layer. If you hit Command or Control R to bring up your ruler, you just bring in a ruler. And then we can add in a path and just draw a line. Then add in a stroke. I want to increase the stroke size here. See, it defaults to 2. Let's just make that 5 so it's a little bit thicker. Okay, and then we can move this ruler back out. Let's right-click, transform, center anchor point, and then make sure this is centered up. So that way it's right in the middle. And make sure your other text layers are also centered. So now we have it completely centered. Okay, so now I want this line to animate in first. So what I do is go to Contents. We're going to add in a Trim Paths. So now if we set both Start and End to 50%. So that way this animation is already halfway complete from the beginning and the end. Put keyframes at the beginning, 20 frames. Now let's increase End to 100% and Start down to 0. So this will animate from the middle out. Highlight these last two keyframes here, ease in, go to our graph editor, and let's just pull that over so that way it starts off fast and then settles slowly. So now I want our top line to animate from underneath this line, and also I want to hide it. So again, this is one of those situations that you may feel the need to add in an alpha matte layer. We don't need to do that. So let's open up our top line here, and we want to add in a position. We'll call this N. We'll move our position for our text animator down, so that way it's about equal with bottom. Open up our advanced, and we want to change our shape to ramp up, and then offset -100%. Put a keyframe, go for 20 frames, increase the offset to 100%. Okay, now I'm going to change this from characters actually to lines, so that way it just does the whole line all at once, like that. And now let's increase our ease low to 100%. Okay, now we're going to want to offset these text layers about 5 frames after our line comes in. So that way the line will come in first and the text will come in like that. Once our text is settled, I'm going to right click, mask, new mask. So that way we don't need our alpha layer. And then see, if you want this to animate where it's even with the line here, you can actually just pull this down. So that way it looks like it's coming up directly from within it. Okay, and now to animate our bottom line, all we have to do is highlight this in Text Animator, and we're going to copy that. Go back to the beginning of our layer here, and then just paste. The one thing we have to change is our position. So our position was 134 for our top line. Let's just make this -135, so that way it starts at the top. And then again, if we right-click, mask, new mask, and that's the animation we have. And I'm going to just set this mask so that way it's even with our line here. Let's pull the mask up. Highlight all of these and enable motion blur for all of them. And then hit U so that way we just see our keyframes. So this is the animation we have. And if we wanted to animate in the opposite direction, again, we're just going to highlight the keyframes, copy, paste, and then highlight these, copy, paste. Just highlight all of these sets, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse. And remember, we want our line animation to be offset from our text. So instead of being behind the line, we want to be in front of our line animation. So if you just page up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, move these keyframes ahead of our line animation, and what we have is something that looks like this. And since this animation has multiple layers, there's a way to save this as a preset. It's going to take a few different steps, but it's not that difficult. We'll start with our line animation. So let's just highlight contents and transform. Go to Animation, Save Animation Preset, and then I'm just going to call this two lines, and then I'll say line animation. So that's going to be our line animation. And save that. For our bottom line here, we'll just click on text and transform. We can go ahead and include mask, but just keep in mind that you have to take it off and put it back on whenever you change whatever text you're using. Go to Animation, Save Animation Preset. And now I want to make sure that I name it the same thing at the beginning. So text animation, two line animation. And we'll call this bottom text. We'll let that save. And then we're going to do the same thing for our top line. Highlight text, mask, and transform. Animation, save animation preset. And we just want to name this top text. Okay, now let's get rid of all of these layers. Go back over to our effects and presets. User presets, 7-minute AE. So here are the presets for that animation right here. Let's go back to the beginning of our layer and just bring these on one at a time. So we'll just double click on our bottom text. Make sure you click away. Double click on our line animation, click away, and top text. Now if we highlight all of these, hit U, we see all of our keyframes came in. And if we play it back, this is the animation that we have. So as you can see, our mask came in because we highlighted our mask whenever we saved this preset. If I need to change this text, say I change this to Jeff Knight, as you can see, this mask doesn't fit because the mask is specific to the text that you apply the mask to. All you have to do is simply take that mask off, right click, mask, new mask, and then it'll put a mask around this text layer, and maybe you want to grab this and move it down. And so now we saw the same animation, but with different text. Okay, and again, remember, highlight these and enable your motion blur once you bring back in a text animator, because it will not automatically include motion blur, as that's not a setting that can be saved as a preset. Okay, so just to recap, whenever you're creating text animations using text animators, remember that your animation comes from the text animator, not from your layer's transform properties, meaning anchor point, position, scale, rotation, or opacity. This allows you the freedom to adjust your text anywhere in your comp while retaining the animation you've created. Text animators give you a lot more freedom than animating with your layer's transform properties. You have options such as animating text by character, word, or line. You also have the ability to randomize how your text animates, again, by character, word, or line. When you have more than one text animator, like in our scale example, you can even change the way your text animates in and then out. You may want to animate in by character, starting with the first character, and animate out randomly by word. These are options you simply don't have with text animation using transform properties. Remember that ease low is pretty much the same thing as ease in, and ease high is pretty much the same thing as ease out. You don't need to add any easy ease to your keyframes when using text animators, so having linear keyframes while using ease high and ease low will get you the look you want. You can, however, add easing if you'd like. Text animators react differently to mask than your layers' transform properties, which is great because using text animators allows you to avoid adding solids or shape layers for alpha mats. You also have no need for set mat. Working with mats can be problematic if you're working on a project with a lot of text because those extra layers can add up quickly and you'll find your timeline unnecessarily crowded. Just remember to add the mask where your text settles because the mask will apply to the text wherever your playhead is located on your timeline. If you need to change text, simply delete the mask on your layer, then right-click and select Mask, New Mask. This option can also be found at Layer, Mask, New Mask. And finally, remember to always add motion blur to text animations. They just look so much better with motion blur. Get in the habit of adding motion blur as soon as you add a text layer, and you won't go wrong. If you're adding a text animator animation preset to your timeline, you'll need to add motion blur every time because that's not a setting that can be saved as a preset. So even if you have motion blur enabled when you save the preset, motion blur will not carry over with the preset. We made 6 text animations using these text animators, so you're on your way to building your own personalized text animation library. These can all be brought in with just a click of a button, so you'll save a ton of time. And we've only just scratched the surface. If you find that you're using the same text animations over and over again, I highly recommend that you save it as a preset for future projects. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you thought about this episode. Hopefully you learned something new and useful. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, to the impressive deals and free stuff you can get from AE Juice, the presets we've created over the last 2 episodes, the notes, and the project files for this series are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.